Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
How are you today?
I'm fine.
So, before we begin this lesson, let's start our lesson today by reciting basmalah together. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Who is absent today? No one?
Yes.
So, everyone is here, right?
Yes.
Before we begin this lesson, have you read the material that I gave you yesterday on our WhatsApp group? Yes, Iqbal?
Yes.
Have you read the material?
Yes.
What is the material about?
It's about invitation, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, it is about invitation. Good, Iqbal. And basically, there are two types of invitation. The first one is formal invitation, and the second one is informal invitation. What we are going to be talking about here today is about formal invitation. And when you hear formal invitation, what is coming up in your mind? What passes through your mind when you hear formal invitation? Iqbal?
Big event.
Big event. Okay, good. What else? What else? Are you ready?
Letter.
Letter? Okay, good. What else?
Invitation card.
Invitation card? Very good. Is there any else?
Request.
Request? Okay. What else?
Accepting or declining.
Accepting or declining. Okay, very good. So, do you guys know what formal invitation is? Yes, Ariadi?
It is an invitation which follows a dignified form, tone, or style in agreement with the established norm, custom, or follows.
Alright, very good, Ariadi. In a simple word, we can say that formal invitation is an invitation that is used to invite someone to a certain or a particular event. For example, it's his name, formal invitation, so that the event or the occasion that is going to be held is supposed to be formal as well. For example, you make an invitation of opening of a school, of the opening of the school. Second, for example, graduation ceremony. Or wedding party, for example. And etc. So, I'll give you 1 minute to, 1 minute to take a look at your book on page 34 and 35. Here, okay? There you will find the characteristic of formal invitation and also the common format layout of formal invitation. 1 minute starts from now. Have you done, everybody? Have you done, Iqbal?
Yes.
Okay, so any question? Any question, guys? So when we make a formal invitation, we have to pay attention on at least 7 components of formal invitation itself. And you can see on your book at on page 34, there you will find the thing that is supposed to be included in our formal invitation. Here I have the example of formal invitation, and I'll hand you this, and later on you will make your own formal invitation by yourself. But first of all, let's see your formal invitation that I've gave you, and or you can see it here on the projection. Okay, so like I said before, that in a good formal invitation, it is supposed to be included at least 7 components. All right, so can you see the invitation, formal invitation that I gave you, or you can see on the projection? On the first line is the board of the directors of the Indonesian Educational Foundation. It is the name of the host or the one who invites you. Okay, so the second line is request the pleasure, which is the expression of asking your participation of their event. And the next one is your name or the name who is the recipient of this invitation. And the next one is the name of the event or the reason why this invitation is made. Okay, Iqbal, please pay attention on me while I'm explaining. Okay, so the next one is the date here. And the next one is the place where the event is going to be held. And as you can see on the left side, it is the contact person. So whether we accept the invitation or decline the invitation, we have to reply to them or to this contact person. In this case, is Edo. So we are going to be talking about this later on the responding card. Okay, so on the bottom right corner, it is dress code, batik, which is the special instruction. If you think that it is unnecessary on your invitation, you can throw this away. Okay, do you have any question, guys? No? Okay, so I have a question. Do you think that this invitation is a good invitation? Is it perfect or is there something missing on it?
Yes, I think it's a good one.
Do you think it is a good one? In my opinion, in this invitation, it is better if they put the time. In this invitation, they only put the date of the event without the time. I know that it is the charity dinner, which is the dinner is they do dinner in the evening, right? But it's still ambiguous or unclear, so that we don't know when the dinner start. Okay, so is there any question?
RSVP itu apa, Pak?
RSVP? Okay, oh yeah, here. RSVP is a French word. It is standing for respondents. I don't know how to pronounce this word, but it is respondents. RSVP, yeah. Play. Which means in English is please reply. You understand?
Yes.
Okay, so let's move on to the responding card. When you got a formal invitation, you must be given a responding card as well, because they came together. And when you get the responding card, you have to fill it with whether you accept the invitation or you decline the invitation. And when you decline the invitation, you have to put or state your reason on the card given. Okay, so here is, let's take a look at your book on page 38. Okay, so here is how the responding card looks like. You will see the blank space so that you can put your decision whether you accept the invitation or not. Later on, you will make your formal invitation and also the responding card as well. Okay, so now it's time for you to make your own formal invitation. So basically, you are going to work in pairs. Iqbal, you're going to work with Aryadi, and you are going to make a formal invitation for Aryadi, and Aryadi is going to make his formal invitation for you. Do you understand? And don't forget to make the responding card as well.
Yes.
Okay, so I'll give you 5 minutes from now. Okay. Have you done, everybody?
Yeah, I'm done.
Okay, now exchange your formal invitation to your partner, and it's time for reply your friend's formal invitation. Okay, very good.
Have you done? Okay, if you decline, don't forget to state your reason here. So you have to put your reason on your calling card, okay? So continue your report. Okay, so if you have done, you may collect your works here on my table. Okay, very good. Now, we still have time. It's time for us to watch a video. Here, I have a video. So, here is the video of how you formally invite someone in spoken English. Okay, so here is the some expression that we can use in formally invite someone to an event, to a particular event. Okay, so that's it guys, and now it's time for you to practice the conversation. Now you are going to, with your partner again, you are going to do a role play or a short conversation which is about the formally invite someone to a particular event. For example, related to your invitation card before. Okay, you ready?
Yes.
Okay, so on my left side is Ariadi, and on my right side is Iqbal. Now, it's your presentation. Time is yours.
Okay. Mr. Yadi, I would like to invite you to the opening of my software company.
When and where?
This Saturday at 10 a.m.
I'm afraid I want to be able to come. I have a poor management.
Okay, then. Thank you, everybody. That's a very good presentation. This is for you.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so that's all for today's meeting. I hope that it will be very beneficial for you guys, especially in the future, in your workplace or anywhere else that formal invitation is needed in your life. Thank you. Thank you for your very nice attention. And let's close our activity today by saying Alhamdulillah together. Alhamdulillah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. See you guys.
Mr. Yadi, I want to invite you to the opening of my software company.
When and where?
This Saturday at 10 a.m.
I want